Oh, yes. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for coming out tonight. Wow, what a huge crowd for this first band concert of the season. We are so happy to see so many people without masks on. That's also a great thing for now. And we're just happy to be up here on stage during a December concert, not in the gymnasium. You might remember a year ago we were in the gym, and that was an interesting experience. Let's just put it that way. But it worked out. So, how about a hand for a percussion ensemble to start off? There's a huge amount of logistics that go into making these concerts happen, especially when you have different ensembles like percussion and jazz and concert bands, as you can already see, the transitions that happen, and also the behind-the-scenes stuff. I'm trying to stay as calm as possible. And calmness for me, these kids already know. It's like, this is like, I think, where am I at, like a 5 right now? Something like that? An 8? Okay, that's pretty close. That's pretty cool. All right, this group right here, Jazz One, they had 7 rehearsals up to this point tonight. They were supposed to tune first beforehand. We did rehearse that, you know, things happen, and it worked out perfectly, so well done. All right, so this next tune is a Duke Ellington tune rearranged for a small combo. This is a combo group. It's a large combo, so we're calling it a little big band. In fact, there are arrangements out there for this sort of group with this sort of instrumentation. So we have 2 tenor saxophones, but 1 tenor sax is actually playing trombone parts specifically written for tenor sax. So it works out really nice and you get a nice balance and blend. So again, we've only had 7 rehearsals in the last 3 weeks. We meet 3 days a week, Monday, Wednesday, Friday, for most of the time. And that's how it works out for the rest of the school year. So this next tune is not a Christmas tune, but it's just another jazz piece by the late, great Duke Ellington. And this will feature a number of people. An alto saxophone, we'll have Riley Hauser, and we'll have on tenor saxophone Jonathan Graycheck, and on piano, Dyson Linden. So here's Cottontail. These guys are going to play two more selections that we kind of sight read a little bit. It's going to be good. It's going to be out in the comments. And then we have a flute trio and a clarinet choir also. And then, of course, there's going to be cookies galore. So we timed this during a rehearsal today. Percussion is set up for the bands in 3 minutes. So we're going to see if they can do it. So let's get them on stage right now. 3 minutes and go. Thank you. All right, so just a little information about this group. This is Braves Band, as you probably read the program. It's primarily made up of freshman students. We do have a number of students in the older class that are only one junior and one sophomore. And we have some extras in here, a few from symphonic band that we threw in there just to kind of cover some more parts. It's a very small group this year, but we're down in numbers and across the music program and choir, band, and orchestra. But we're working with what we have, and the students that we have are really awesome and motivated, and it's just great. Another thing about this group is there's quite a few beginners or students who didn't have band or kind of didn't have band for about a year, you know, because of the pandemic. And so we're kind of dealing with that too as well. And that makes it fairly challenging to get those students up to speed. But I think they did a pretty good job, would you think? Don't lie. All right, so if you live under a rock, you probably have never heard this song. Or if you're my father who's in the audience tonight, you're wishing for this, let us know.
Thank you.
This year we actually did 4 football games. We did a trip to Bozeman for the showcase event, which is kind of like a non-competitive exhibition type competition. And I have to say that this season was probably one of our best to date. We had excellent leadership in all sections, especially in the drum major positions. And honestly, our students after the end of the season were so inspired, especially from the trip to Bozeman, after seeing 3 competitive marching bands perform, and then 3 other ones that were non-competitive, they're just like, I want to do that. And so I think you're going to see some really interesting, great, and different things next year, and I'm really excited about that. And in that regard, regarding marching band, sorry to repeat my words there, but off the cuff, we are actually in the process of trying to get new uniforms, believe it or not. And that process is a bit complicated, and right now I'm working with a company called Tumulin, which is a very well-known uniform company which made our marching band uniforms back in, get this, 1970. Okay? So ours are 51 years old. Most of these students, a lot of these students have grandparents that wore those uniforms. So I'd say it's kind of time to get new uniforms, don't you think? So our administration is working on that, my department head's working on it, my band parent organization is working on that. There's going to be more information about what kind of uniform we're going to get, the design that we're doing. The students are part of that process, and I think you'll really like what we're going to come up with. And it's not a cheap thing to get brand new uniforms for a marching band, but it's something that will last for a number of years. Hopefully we'll still have them when I retire, so I don't have to worry about them. So that's kind of the idea. But anyway, the season was fantastic, and something that was brought up today in class that I thought about, and we actually discussed, was doing some kind of marching band awards during this concert, because we don't really have a way to kind of wrap things up at the end of the season. We have some discussions in class and a few other things that we do, but that's pretty much it. We have one more performance and then we're done. So tonight, there was not going to be awards, but in the near future, there will be an announcement put out there for a couple of awards that we do have for marching band. One of them is the national award that goes on a plaque in our hallway, which currently there are no plaques because we took them down for painting, but we have plaques that are usually up in the performing arts area where the choir and band rooms are. So that those students would be on those plaques, and they also receive an award for themselves. So anyway, I just thought I'd let you know that. By the way, tonight's performance is, if I have my numbers correct, this is the 12th public performance of these students tonight, since the beginning of the school year. You count all the mandatory marching band performances, the one volleyball pep band game that we did, pep assemblies that we've done already, and now this concert tonight. These kids have been so busy, and we've only had, like I said, about a month to get ready. So I think these kids deserve a huge round of applause for all of them. If you recognize both tunes in this piece, please sing along in tune. So it looks really beautiful in here, and most of the decorations come between the band room, but a lot of them come from the choir, so thank you, Mrs. Stevens and choir, for all the Christmas decorations, as you'll also see at the choir concert in a couple of weeks. I'd also like to thank the band parents in advance. Band Parents, Inc. is a nonprofit organization that do a lot of logistics for the band. We got it restarted this summer. It's always been in existence, but we got our board of directors, our executive board put together. There are three parents involved with that. President is Nora Bledsoe, Vice President is Donna Elder, and Secretary of Treasurer is Dana Dorch. Those three ladies and anybody else that's volunteering tonight will be outside, handing those tables, serving you hot cider and cookies, all right? So don't be a cookie hoarder. Save some for everybody, all right? Okay. All right, let's give them a hand, please. Yes. Because there's a lot of administrative stuff that the band director does in order to keep things going, and it's crazy. So it's like, I get here usually at 7:30 in the morning, and I don't usually leave until 6. I usually have a time limit. I can stay later if I have to sometimes, but I try to get out of here at 6 o'clock, which is still a pretty long day of just constant work and things that have to get done, and I'm never caught up. I'm always behind. And so these parents do an excellent job of doing this, especially during the marching band season. I mean, they took care of the students as far as like snacks right after school before marching band practices, all of the lunches and dinners before games and during games, water during marching band camp. I mean, you name it. I mean, it really just made things so much easier. I didn't have to worry about organizing all of those things that, you know, make sure the kids are comfortable, and those parents made that happen. And if you talk to any one of these students that was involved this year in marching band, they will tell you that it was because of those parents that marching band was so much better this year, in addition to all the other things I said earlier about their leadership. So would you give those parents, please, another round of applause? So it seems like the trajectory with community organizations like Lions, Rotary, you name it, it seems like there's always a few people in those organizations. There might be a huge membership, but there's only a handful of people that really do most of the work. And honestly, we need as many of you as possible to make this band parent group as involved and more successful. By the way, your kids are part of this program. And if you want your kids to be successful and happy, get involved, okay? It doesn't mean showing up to meetings or anything like that. I think they maybe had maybe 2 or 3 since August. And we met once at Mackenzie River Pizza, and there might have been a frothy beverage involved, like a root beer or a soda, okay? You know, things like that. So get involved with them and read the emails that they send out. So choose it from Flathead Band Parents, @FlatheadBandParents, or @Nora Bledsoe@yahoo.com. Check your emails, because I send emails out too regarding this program and newsletters every Sunday, and then band parents send out stuff too. I know you get a flood of stuff, but please check those, because they're a great deal of information that'll keep you up to date on what's happening in this program. And so you know what's going on, so your kid is up to date as well, all right? Thank you so much for coming out tonight. Thank you, Nick Tobiasen, for your sound and for the lighting and everything else for tonight. He's up in the booth up there. Please give him a hand. More stuff for you, so remember those cookies, and there's going to be a flute trio, clarinet choir, and then our Jasmine will be out there again as well. Wait around, the kids are going to change out of their uniforms afterwards, and then just eat some cookies and enjoy the cider. Here's one of my favorite songs for Christmas by Andy Williams. You know, you remember that old singer from back in the day? Yeah, maybe, Andy Williams. Oh yeah, it's the most wonderful time of the year, depending on what family you're from. Here we go. Thanks again, everybody. Have a wonderful night. And next week, come back for an orchestra concert on this night, Thursday night next week. And then the week after that, on Tuesday the 16th, choir, two concerts, 4:30 and 7 o'clock. Have a great night. Thank you.